The Ukrainian army continued the shelling of Slavyansk from the Belyansky hills. In the morning, Semyonovka was shelled again. At midday time, the Ukrainian regime army started the shelling of village Krasny Partizan and mine near it. Ukrainian army continued to draw military hardware to Slavyansk. They drove it from the side of Krasny Oskol, Izum, in the direction of Yatskaya and Krasny Liman. Ukrainian army blew up railway section between stations Starusa Ogorodnye near the station Luganskaya. Now it can cause the problems with trains traffic from the direction of Moscow. The Kyiv authorities and the authorities of People's Republics arrange a ceasefire till 10 a.m. o'clock June 27. But the situation in Slavyansk proves that Kyiv is not going to observe the condition of ceasefire. Deputy of Verkhovnaya Rada of Ukraine Oleg Leshko said that the squadron Azov, which takes part in punitive operation on east of Ukraine, on half is composed of previously convicted persons. But the people's deputy can't see anything bad in that fact. European Union assessments of events in Ukraine are biased, politically charged and unreal, the Russian foreign minister said on Tuesday in comments of the European Council meeting results on June 23. Is it possible to explain in other way the lack of any mention about the death of tens of children? Move the thousand flow of refugees who kept coming to Russia from Ukraine. Numerous transgression of Russian state border by the Ukrainian military. And an indignant attempt at storming the Russian embassy in Kyiv in European Council's conclusions, the Russian Foreign Ministry contemplated.